for me, it was a double sort of double-edged sword. Watching her health deteriorate and watching my dad primarily and my younger brother who was living at home at the time as her daily 24/7 healthcare providers, that was hard to watch. My sister and I would also help out with respite whenever we could. But we did the best we could as a family. The other side of that was the healthcare system almost insisting that she be under their care. It was interesting because she was hospitalized occasionally. She was in and out for surgeries and chemotherapy and radiation treatments over the many years. But she always insisted on coming home. And the reluctance of the healthcare, particularly the doctors, to let her go home without home care, in fact, you know, insisting that she have home care. And she would inevitably let them go. She would say, "You've done your job and I don't need you, we don't need you, we're good to go." So she struggled with that whole idea of having strangers, I think, looking after her. That was very difficult for her. And the other sort of, I think, hard part was the fact that it was really challenging culturally to find people within the healthcare system who could relate to us as a family, as a Métis family. Our values around family are very strong. We have, we have cared for people in our family for many generations, and that's a value that we really hold dear and near and in our hearts.